Hey guys, it's Glenn from glennscarcollection.com. It's another gloomy day here in New Jersey, so I hope the weather is better where you are. And in this video, I'm gonna be taking your questions, and in an upcoming video, I will answer those questions. So this is another question and answer video. We haven't done one of these in a long time, and I think we should do this on a more regular basis. Now, how do you make sure you don't miss the answer video? Well, what you do is you hit the subscribe first, and then hit the notification bell. The notification bell will email you every time I post a video. Remember to like and share these videos with your friends so our channel can grow and I keep making videos. We're pushing 7,000 subscribers right now at the time that I'm filming this. Remember, when we get to 10,000 subscribers, we'll buy a project car. So if you're not subscribed, subscribe. Get a couple of your friends to subscribe so we can get to that 10,000 subscriber pretty quickly. All right, so we're gonna do a question and answer video. So you're gonna leave a question in the comments below. Make sure it's a car related question. If we have too many questions, I'll answer it in another video, but hopefully, we'll have enough questions. I'll pick the best ones and we'll answer it. So you may have questions about, buying a car. You may be considering a couple different cars and you wanna know what my opinion is. Maybe I've done two reviews of similar cars that compete against each other and you wanna know which one I like better. Maybe you wanna compare different M3s, pluses and minuses, or M5s, or Porsches, or NSXs, or S2000s, or, you're buying a car across country and you wanna know what to do. Stuff like that would be certainly all appropriate topics for this question answer video. So leave your questions below and I will answer them in a future video. Remember to hit that notification bell so you don't miss the answers. We have over 500 videos. I said this in a previous video. So how many have you watched? The weekends are a great time to binge watch these videos and of course share them with your friends. We have a Mercedes SLS Black Series video, Ferrari F50, F40, Enzo. We have a lot of exotic cars. We have a Vector video. Make sure you see that. That video does really well. We have long-term tests on all my cars, the M2, the 1 Series M, the Z3 M Coupe, the NSX, the 9N3 Turbo, previous cars that I sold this year like the GLA 45 or the S2000. So if you ever thought about those cars, you can see some long-term tests on those. I've just driven about a dozen press cars. So we're gonna have those videos coming over a couple months. Again, that's why I'm telling you to hit the notification bell so you don't miss those. But I'm really looking forward to your questions and we'll try to do this questions and answer stuff more often. And it really can be on a broad range of topics. We will have videos coming out where we'll have some more comparison tests. I just filmed my 1 Series M versus the Z3 M Coupe. So those are two very rare BMW M cars. The BMW 1M here in the United States, they only made 740 copies. And here in the United States for the S54, Z3 M Coupe with the S54 engine, which comes from the E46 M3, they only made 678 of those. So those are very rare cars, 740 to 678. One's turbocharged, obviously, one's normally aspirated. And they're actually 10 years apart, at least my cars are. BMW 1 Series M here in the United States was only made 2011. I don't care what you say on the internet because they have production numbers wrong. They have model years wrong. A lot of people say it's a 2012. No, in the United States, it was only 2011. And then obviously the Z3 M Coupe is a really interesting car. It's minus 10 years older than the 1 Series M. So 2011 for the 1 Series M, 2001 for the Z3 M Coupe. So that'll be a great comparison test. And you can see which is best for you. Obviously, I love both cars. The GLA 45, if you haven't seen our 18-month review on that, that's a good video to check out. So that'll give you, pluses and minuses of owning that car. And that car is really a hoot to drive. I love the engine in that car. My BMW M2, we have our two-year review. I've had it over 2 years, 2.5 years. But the last long-term review of it I did was 2 years. So that's good to see. And, we did a long-term review on my Porsche 993 Turbo. And that is for sale. So if anybody's interested in that car, send me an email if you want to know price. All the specs on that car are in the video. But if you're interested in price, certainly email me at glennscarcollection@gmail.com. And remember to leave your questions below. and I will answer it in an upcoming video. Thanks again for watching, guys. Thanks again for your continued support over these 2 years, whether you subscribed last week or you subscribed 2 years ago. So I appreciate it. Remember to leave a comment on every single video, and I will see you guys next time here on Glenn's Car Collection. And thanks again for the continued support, and hope you had a great Thanksgiving, and I will see you next time. Remember, we post videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.